The mean variance and standard deviation of a discrete probability distribution. For example, suppose a classroom is randomly selected at a state university. Researchers want to determine the probability that a student is taking exactly 4 classes. The data collected created the following discrete probability distribution. Using the discrete probability distribution, compute the mean, variance, and standard deviation. To compute the mean, variance, and standard deviation of a discrete probability distribution, we use the following formulas. The mean, also known as the expected value, is represented as mu, and that is equal to the sum of the quantity of each x value times its corresponding probability. The variance, which is represented as sigma squared, is equal to the sum of the x squared values times its corresponding probability minus the mean squared. The standard deviation which is equal to sigma is found by taking the square root of the variance. So first, we are going to compute the mean. And the mean is found by taking each x times its corresponding probability and then summing them together. So our first x value was 3, and we're going to multiply that by its corresponding probability of 3 over 23, and that's equal to 0.3913. Our second x value was 4, and multiplied by its corresponding probability of 8 over 23, and that's equal to 1.3913. Our next x was 5, and 5 times its corresponding probability of 9 over 23 is equal to 1.9565. And finally, our last x value of 6 times its corresponding probability of 3 over 23 is equal to 0.7826. Our next step is to sum them. So now that we've multiplied each x times its corresponding probability, we're going to add them together. So we have 0.3913 plus 1.3913 plus 1.9565 plus 0.7826. And that sums to 4.5217. And so this tells us the average number of classes a student is taking is 4.5 classes. To compute the variance, and again the notation for the variance is sigma squared, we're going to sum the squared x values times its corresponding probability minus the mean squared. So again, we're going to square each x, multiply it by its corresponding probability, add them together, and then subtract out the mean squared. So our first x value was 3, so we're going to take 3 squared and multiply it by its corresponding probability of 3 over 23. And that's equal to 1.1739. Our next x value was 4, so 4 squared times its corresponding probability of 8 over 23. Is equal to 5.5652. Our next x was 5. So 5 squared times its corresponding probability of 9 over 23 is equal to 9.7826. And finally, our last x of 6, so 6 squared times its corresponding probability of 3 over 23 is equal to 4.6957. So now that we've done this piece, we're going to sum them. So we're going to add them all together. So I have 1.1739 plus 5.5652 plus 9.7826 plus 4.6957. And once I add all of them together, I end up with 21.2174. So now that I've done this first part, I am now going to subtract out the mean squared. So 21.2174 minus the mean, and the mean from the previous screen was 4.5217. So we square that. And once we perform the math, we end up with 0.7716. So the variance is 0.7716. Finally, to compute the standard deviation, and the notation for the standard deviation is simply sigma, which is found by taking the square root of the variance. And we found the variance to be 0.7716. So once we take the square root of that, we end up with 0.878. And so the standard deviation is 0.878.